Öffentliche Theologie ist der Versuch,
public theology strives to make use of the Christian tradition for addressing those questions that are currently being discussed in the public domain. Topics such as justice, ecology, conservation of nature, or overcoming violence. These are being discussed politically, but they also have moral and ethical dimensions.
Public theology is when theology translates into the public square. It does so in a number of different ways. It works through the pronouncements and actions of official religious bodies, such as churches, but perhaps more importantly, it's there in the way people of faith mobilize within public domain in pursuit of actions of social justice, social welfare, building up the neighborhood, helping one another in the community, and so on.
Öffentliche Theologie denkt darüber nach.
Public theology reflects on which contributions to the common good a religion such as Christianity can make. And the characteristic thing about it is that public theology does so in a pluralistic society, accepting that it is only one voice among many other possible voices.
Eine Stimme ist unter vielen anderen möglichen Stimmen.
I'm from South Africa, and in our case, Archbishop Tutu Emeritus, Archbishop Tutu once said that through his life he became more and more aware of how much faith and theology matters for public life. So I would say public theology for us is born in this conviction that faith matters for public life, but it matters in deeply contested and controversial and also problematic ways. So at the heart of the theology part is this self-awareness that we must learn and be learned by others and find out the good and the bad possibilities that there are.
Learning from each other, finding out what public theology can mean in concrete situations, this was also the aim of an international conference, the Nuremberg Forum, that took place at the German Friedrich Alexander University Erlangen-Nuremberg in October 2016. More than 120 participants from around the world and from different religions met to discuss major aspects of public theology. How can insights that come from a specific religion contribute to the common good of all in a society in which people with such diverse religious and secular worldviews are living together? As the conference impressively showed, it's not only Christian theologians who are concerned with this question. During a panel discussion, Jewish, Islamic, and Buddhist scholars also exchanged perspectives. Their statements clearly show that in all the great world religions, there is a religiously motivated commitment to promoting the benefit of all people. Therefore, communication and collaboration across religions and worldviews is a fundamental component of public theology.
It's the reason why I took the trouble to come here during what is otherwise a very busy season in the Jewish religious calendar, because I think it's so vital. What it says that from our different religious perspectives, we all have a stake in what goes on in the public debate. And that's how I understand public theology. I don't understand it as a distinctively Christian term. What I understand it to mean is that every faith, Baha'i, Hinduism, Buddhism, Judaism, certainly of a variety of different kinds of Christianity, and then also secular faiths or secular views that don't choose to call themselves faith, all of them have a role in the debate that we need to carry out in the public square in order to figure out how to live together. And if we exclude religious people from that debate, I don't know how we're going to figure out how to live together. If you just look at what's happening in the American context, where the debate between evangelical Christians on the one hand and diehard liberals on the other has become so acrimonious that they can't even listen to one another because we have no common place in order to sit down, even though those evangelicals and diehard liberals share many, many more things in common than they actually differ. But they never have the chance to talk to each other about them in order to discover the ways in which they are the same and in order to craft together the life they wish to share. That's the task of public debate in a liberal society, and theology has an important role to play in that discussion.
From the perspective of Islamic theology, openness to diversity and a willingness to learn from each other belong to the core of the Islamic faith.
The Quran acknowledges that there will be diversity, a difference. So how does the Quran actually define the category of being, human being, within the context and possibility of different expressions of being human? Well, the answer of the Quran is very simple. The very famous verse says, "We have created you in one essence as man, woman, as people of different languages and tribes, in fact, even religions, according to some commentators, so that, the Quran says, you should be able to have the opportunity of learning from one another.
Belief in God does not play a decisive role in Buddhism, unlike in the so-called Abrahamic religions of Judaism, Christianity, and Islam. But mindfulness and a metaphysical dimension are essential to Buddhist spiritual thought.
Buddhism can be taken as a religion, but also as a spirituality, but also as education for cultivating certain kind of consciousness that will contribute to peace and so on. So I think if we can stretch the meaning of theology so that theology is not just identified with the monotheistic worldview, then definitely there's a room for Buddhism to get in and to express its views and make a contribution. In my Canadian setting, what's happening is mindfulness, which is one of the Buddhist practices, right, is taken up big time by educational settings for sure, schools for sure, but healthcare systems and all sorts of other places, including military, by the way. And the way it's taken is because mindfulness trains people's attention and awareness and make people efficient, reduce anxiety, stress. It's just that way it's taken up.
But how do secular people view the discussion around public theology? The well-known Egyptologist and cultural scientist Professor Jan Assmann calls himself a secular scholar. At the conference, he gave a keynote speech on the light and shade of biblical religion. Can he see something positive in the notion of public theology?
Yes, indeed. I came across the notion today for the first time. I also didn't know it originated in Christianity, but I find it really good, because I imagine that the addition of public to the notion of theology opens up a transreligious, universalistic or cosmopolitan perspective. A theology that is not self-centered, so to speak, but opens itself up to other religions and by doing so also sees a chance of understanding itself better by learning to look at itself through the eyes of others.
This conference, the 12th Nuremberg Forum, gave special emphasis to the relationship between public theology and public education. Several papers dealt with public schools or with the school subject of religious education. There was consensus that the links between public theology and education are essential and close.
Public theology and education are inseparably connected, as public theology is trying to reflect on its religious traditions so that people can relate to them responsibly and so that these traditions can be passed on to other people in a responsible manner. This is why public theology is the foundation for educational endeavors in schools and other public domains. Theology guarantees that the contents of such educational practices are substantial and well considered.
Inhalt der Bildung ist, auch wirklich Substanz hat und auch wirklich gut überlegt ist.
Religion in public school. I come from Sweden. We have a non-confessional school subject, religion education, where all students from different backgrounds come to the same classroom. I think that it's important that students get knowledge that is based on academic academically based knowledge in the schools, in schools, because they need to counter the whole media, what media presents, social media, different kinds of media, how they present religions. And as we know, that is in many times often very negative, especially when it comes to Islam. There are research that shows that the word Islam and Muslim are connected to negative terms, like 70% or 80%, if not more today. And I think then it's very important that religious education or religion education brings accurate knowledge to the students. And it's also a possibility for a space where you can discuss religion, no matter where you come from. So I find it a very important school subject today.
I've been talking in my paper this week about the need for religious literacy. Again, people are aware of faith in the world and its impact, but very often they don't have much understanding, let alone first-hand knowledge. So really to pursue religious literacy is a primary goal, I think, of education. Not just learning about a religion and what it believes, but actually having the opportunity to encounter and engage in dialogue with people of all faiths and none.
Öffentliche Theologie hat immer etwas mit Bildung. Public theology is always linked with education because it wants to influence consciousness. It wants to show ways to change our society. And this corresponds to the basic assertion of public theology. Our Christian perspective has something to say for all people, irrespective of their religion or secularity. This is in fact an approach that has always been characteristic of religious education in German schools. The aim of RE is to be a benefit to all the students in RE classes. Not in the way that we try to convert them, but rather that, for instance, Muslim students or secular students also can take away something for themselves that helps them in their lives, that maybe even helps them to live their faith or worldview in a better and more reflective way.
Das ist als der christliche Glaube, intensiver, besser, humaner leben zu können.
Many conference participants expressed the wish that besides global problems generated mainly by extreme forms of religion, the positive influences that various religions bring should receive more attention. Public theology wants to support such positive contributions and to enable people to reflect critically as well as self-critically on relevant issues. As many people have stressed, this is especially crucial in the areas of public media and public education. It's in line with this perspective that the organizer of the conference, Professor Pirner, established a research unit for public religion and education at the University of Erlangen-Nürnberg. The unit's task is to investigate and discuss links between public theology and education. And it also aims to make research results and insights from public theology accessible to a wider public.